ELISA is a plate-based assay technique designed for detecting and quantifying soluble substances, such as antibodies, antigens, proteins, peptides, and hormones. ELISA assays are categorized into various types. In this video, we will focus on sandwich ELISA and explore how it can be applied to detect and quantify thyroid-stimulating hormone present in a sample. The crucial first step of sandwich ELISA is plate coating. To begin, samples are placed in a designated area, and for the coating step, 96 well plates or 8 well strips are commonly used. The well strip is positioned in a support frame. Next, a specific primary antibody designed to bind to TSH is used to coat the well strip. The primary antibody solution is added into the wells, ensuring that each well receives the appropriate volume. Next, the well strip is covered with adhesive plastic to create a controlled environment for an incubation process. In ELISA, polystyrene stands as the widely preferred material for the solid phase. Antibodies are then immobilized onto this polystyrene surface. After immobilizing antibodies onto the solid phase, the adhesive plastic is removed. The well strip is then overturned and tapped to eliminate antibody solutions, and an absorbent paper towel is used to ensure thorough removal. After eliminating excess solutions, the wells undergo thorough washing with a specially formulated wash buffer. This solution rinses the wells, removing any unbound substances. Using a wash buffer helps eliminate any unbound antibodies. After discarding the wash buffer, an absorbent paper towel is used to remove any remaining liquid. The next step in sandwich ELISA is to block any unoccupied sites on the solid phase. During this step, a blocking solution is applied, usually containing proteins like BSA, serum, non-fat dry milk, or casein. The blocking solution is added to each well. Subsequently, the well strip is covered and incubated. The proteins in the blocking solution form a barrier on the plate, preventing substances from binding to these sites in subsequent steps. After completing the blocking step, the adhesive plastic is removed, followed by the discarding of the blocking solutions. An absorbent paper towel is then used to thoroughly absorb any remaining solution. Next, the wells are thoroughly washed with the wash buffer. This step helps to ensure that any remaining blocking protein is thoroughly removed from the wells. After discarding the wash buffer, any residual liquid is removed using an absorbent paper towel. After the blocking step, the subsequent stage involves incubation with the samples. Prior to loading the samples, standard solutions with various known concentrations of TSH are added into the wells. These standards serve as reference points to establish a quantification curve for measuring the TSH levels in the samples. Following the addition of standard solutions, each sample is carefully placed into its corresponding well. Next, the well strip is covered and incubated. Incubation facilitates the binding of TSH, present in both the samples and standards, to the immobilized antibodies. Next, the solutions are removed from the wells, ensuring the elimination of any remaining liquid. The next critical step is to perform a thorough wash to remove any unbound substances. The washing step effectively removes both unbound substances and unbound TSH, leaving only the specific antibody hormone complexes. The next step involves incubation with a secondary antibody, which is a conjugated antibody designed to enable the detection and quantification of targeted TSH. The secondary antibody solution is added to each well, and then the well strip is covered and incubated. The secondary antibody is specifically designed to bind to the targeted thyroid-stimulating hormone present in the wells. Next, the secondary antibody solution is removed from each well. Following the use of the conjugated antibody, the next crucial step involves performing a final wash to remove any excess secondary antibody. The wash buffer effectively removes any unbound antibody, leaving only the specific sandwich complexes. Following the final wash, the next critical step involves detection and quantification. This is achieved using a substrate that initiates a reaction, producing a detectable signal. The substrate solution is carefully added to each well. Then the well strip is covered and incubated. The detection antibody is typically labeled with an enzyme, such as alkaline phosphatase. The most common chromogenic substrate for this enzyme is p-nitrophenylphosphate, PNPP. The alkaline phosphatase enzyme catalyzes the cleavage of phosphate groups from PNPP molecules. This enzymatic reaction transforms PNPP into p-nitrophenyl, which generates a yellow color upon deprotonation in an alkaline medium. In the presence of TSH, a color change takes place, causing the wells to display a yellow color. Next, prior to photometric detection, the reaction is commonly stopped by increasing the pH of the reaction mixture, using a strong base such as NaOH. Finally, a spectrometer instrument is utilized to measure the absorbance in each well, allowing for the quantification of TSH levels. Using the absorbance values of standard points, a calibration curve is constructed. This curve enables the determination of TSH concentration in samples.